Praise the Lord. Welcome, Angel TV viewers, to Gateway to Heaven program.
赞美主，欢迎收看天使电视天堂之门的系列。
I want to minister a word to you today called the anointing that breaks the yoke.
今天要分享的题目是神的恩膏打断我们的轭。
In Isaiah chapter 10 verse 27 it says,
以赛亚书第十章二十七节这样说，
The yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing.
因着神的恩膏，所以你的轭必打断。
So this anointing that we are talking about in the Bible, it says it is the manifest power of the Holy Spirit.
我们所讲到的这一个恩膏呢，就是圣灵所彰显的能力。
And this anointing, how it works, is expressed to us in the Bible in Mark chapter 5.
那么这一个恩膏是如何运行的呢？就可以在马可福音第五章看到了。
We see this anointing being demonstrated in the case of the woman who had the issue of blood.
这个恩膏是怎么样彰显的呢？在那一位有血漏的妇人的身上，我们就可以清楚的看到。
Let's look together at Mark 5 verses 25 to 34.
让我们一起来看马可福音第五章二十五到三十四节。
And there was a woman who had a flow of blood for 12 years, and who had endured much suffering under the hands of many physicians, and had spent all that she had, and was no better, but instead worse. She had heard the reports concerning Jesus. She came up behind him in the throng and touched his garment, for she kept saying, If I only touched his garment, I shall be restored to health.And immediately her flow of blood was dried up at the source, and suddenly she felt in her body that she was healed of her distressing ailment. And Jesus, recognizing himself that the power proceeding from him had gone forth, turned around immediately in the crowd and said, Who touched my clothes? And the disciples kept saying to him, You see the crowd pressing hard around you from all sides, and you ask, Who touched me?Still, he kept looking around to see her who had done it. But the woman, knowing what had been done for her, too alarmed and frightened and trembling, fell down before him and told him the whole truth. And he said to her daughter, Your faith, your trust and confidence in me, springing from faith in God, has restored you to health. Go in peace and be continuously healed and freed from your disease.
有一个女人患了十二年的血漏，在好些医生手里受了许多的苦，又花尽了她所有的，一点也不见好，病势反倒更重了。她听见耶稣的事，就从后头来夹在众人中间摸耶稣的衣裳，意思说，我只摸他的衣裳就必痊愈。于是她血漏的源头立刻干了，她便觉得身上的灾病好了，耶稣顿时心里觉得有能力从自己身上出去，就在众人中间转过来说：“谁摸我的衣裳？”门徒对他说：“你看众人拥挤你，还说谁摸我吗？”耶稣周围观看，要见做这事的女人，那女人就知道在自己身上所成的事，就恐惧战惊。来俯伏在耶稣跟前，将实情全告诉他。耶稣对他说：“女儿，你的信救了你，平平安安的回去吧，你的灾病痊愈了。”
There are two words that are very important in the healing of this woman.
在医治这个女人的过程当中，有两个字非常重要。
It was virtue and faith.
那就是品格和信心。
See, virtue in Greek is translated dunamis power.
在希腊文，品格的意思呢，就是自然的能力。
See, when Jesus was touched by this woman, he knew that power had left him.
你看，当耶稣被这个女人摸着的时候呢，他发觉到有能力从他的身上出去了。
That's why he asked. He says, "Who touched me?"
这就是为什么呢？耶稣问谁摸我了。
See, when the woman said that she touched him,
当这个女人说我摸你的时候
He said to the woman, thy faith has made you whole.
耶稣就对她说女儿你的信救了你
But Jesus said it was your faith that made you whole.
但是呢耶稣对她说是你的信救了你
Imagine climbing a mountain.
让我们想象看在攀登一座山
When you look from one side of the mountain, you will see a view.
当你从山的这一边的时候呢，你会看到一部分的景象。
And then you'll look on the other side, and you'll see another view.
山的另外一头呢，你又看到不一样的风景。
Now, which view you like depends upon you.
你喜欢哪一边的风景呢？完全在于你要看哪一方面。
See, Bible truth is the same way.
同样的，圣经的真理也一样。
See, one side was healing virtue coming forth from Jesus that affected her body.
一方面呢，就是医治，就是从耶稣身上自然流露出来的能力。
On the other side, it was her faith that healed her.
另外一方面呢，就是她的信心救了她。
See, it was only when her faith was activated that the yoke of bondage was broken off of her.
只有当他启动自己的信心的时候，他身上的轭才能够被打断。
See, when Jesus asked his disciple, "Who touched me?"
当耶稣问门徒说，谁摸我
？The disciples responded, "You are crowded by so many people. We don't know who touched you."
门徒的回答就是，这么多人围绕着你，谁知道谁动了你呢
？See, if you were in a crowd and everybody was touching you.
那要是你在群众的当中，每个人都在碰触你。
The power of God is not just activated by just a mere touch.
只是让人碰触，并不能够启动神的大能。
See, many people today try to touch Jesus just to see if anything would happen.
今天很多人也想摸一摸耶稣，看看到底有什么事情发生。
But see, God's power is not activated by curious touch.
可是一个出于好奇的触摸并不能够启动神的大能。
See, it is the touch of faith that releases the power of God.
只有信心的触摸才能够释放神的大能。
See, we know Jesus was anointed with power because what it says in Acts 10:38.
在《使徒行传》第十章第三十八节，我们可以看到主耶稣是如何行使他的大能。
It says how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power.
这里说神怎样以圣灵和能力告拿撒勒人耶稣。
In Luke 4, Jesus said,
在路加福音第四章主耶稣说
He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he hath anointed me.
神的灵在我的身上因为神要恩膏我。
See, we know that Jesus was anointed or empowered by the Holy Spirit.
我们知道耶稣是蛮有恩膏的，是圣灵赐给他大能。
See, most of the time, Jesus did not heal because of the anointing.
很多时候，耶稣并不是因为他只有恩膏，所以才进行医治。
Most of the time, the other person's faith had to be involved.
但是很多时候，另外一个人的信心必须参与其中。
Where do you read in the Bible where it says, "By my faith you were healed"?
圣经在什么地方你读过说你是因着我的信心被医治的呢？
He said it was by your faith you were healed.
可是耶稣却说是因着你的信心你得医治了。
See, we need to know that God is everywhere all the time.
我们必须认识到神是无所不在的。
So if he's everywhere, that means his power is everywhere.
如果神是无所不在的，换句话说，他的能力也无所不在。
It might not be manifested, but it's there.
虽然他没有彰显出来，不过神的能力是在的。
See, the reason it is not manifested all the time, because many times the faith of the person is not there.
神的能力有时候没有办法彰显出来，是因为我们的信心没有行使出来。
See, one has to...activate their faith to manifest the power of God.
因为一个人要启动他的信心，然后呢，神的大能才会跟着彰显出来。
Let me give you an example.
让我给你举个例子。
Let's say you are plugging a fan in the electric.
比方说你给电风扇
And on a hot summer day to activate the electricity to have the fan run.
在炎热的夏天呢你要启动这个电源让风扇能够转动
And the fan will produce cool air.
这样风扇呢就会吹出凉风
But if you do not plug the fan in, it's not going to work.
但是如果电风扇没有插上电源风扇就不能够操作
You'll have to sit in a hot room.
你就得在炎热的房间里面坐着。
So you have the fan.
所以你有一把风扇。
You have the electricity.
你有电源。
But it's not working.
但是不会操作。
So what good is it to you?
所以对你一点好处都没有。
The Bible says in Mark 11:24.
在马可福音第十一章二十四节这样说。
What things soever you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them and ye shall have them.
凡你们祷告祈求的，无论是什么，只要信是得着的，就必得着。
Prayer without belief will not give you any results.
要是你祷告了而没有信心，那是不会产生果效的。
Many people pray, they believe, but they don't know how to receive.
很多人他们祷告了他们也相信但是不知道怎么样领受
You know, they'll say, Pastor, I've been praying for 6 months for such and such thing and nothing is happening.
他们会对你说牧师啊我为这件事已经祷告了6个月了但是什么事情都没有发生
And God is giving them answers, but they don't know how to receive.
其实神已经应允了他们的祷告但是他们不知道怎么样的领受
So next time when you pray,
所以下一回你祷告的时候
Mix your receiving part with your believing part
让你的接收器和信心要结合在一起
See, we have to see it before we receive it
我们在领受前必须先看见
Or you won't get it
否则你就不会得到
See, all we have to do is praise the Lord and be happy on the inside and just receive what we have prayed and we'll get it
我们所要做的就是赞美主，然后心里面欢喜快乐，然后呢，就高高兴兴的等着领受神所要给我们的。
See, God's presence is all around us.
神是无所不在的。
And when His presence is there, His power is there.
只要有神在的地方，就有神的大能。
And if we don't make a choice to plug ourselves into that power to receive His blessings,
如果我们并不和这个大能连接在一起来领受它的福气
It would be like that fan that I spoke to you about
那么就好像我们刚才所提到的电风扇
You say I'll have the fan
你说我有风扇
And I have the electricity
我也有电源
And I'm waiting for the electricity to make this fan run
我等着那个电源啊来启动这把风扇
See, the electricity cannot make the fan run until you plug it in.
你看，电源无法启动风扇，直到你把风扇插上电源才可以。
See, that's how it is with God. Many times we're in the presence of God and His manifest power is right there.
这和神的情况是一样的。神同在的时候，他的大能就要彰显。
And we come out of that place disappointed and say, God didn't do anything for me.
可是从那里出来我们感到非常的失望因为我们认为神没有为我们做什么
See, God was there to meet your need
神在那里要满足你的需要
But you chose not to get plugged into that power
但是你选择不要插上这个电源
Just like that woman with the issue of blood
就好像那个血漏的女人一样
She had spent everything that she had
她花尽了自己所有的
She was getting desperate
他已经非常的绝望。
She had one choice.
他只有一个选择。
And she had believed.
他必须要相信。
That if I can touch the hem of his garment, I will be made whole.
只要我能摸着他的衣裳，我就痊愈了。
See, she had belief, she had the power, and she also received.
你看到吗？他相信，他有了大能，他也去领受。
See, as those three ingredients mix together, the anointing will break the yoke of bondage off of your life.
当这三个要素结合在一起的时候，神的恩膏就能够打断你身上的轭。
See, we need to activate our faith.
你看到吗？我们要启动自己的信心。
And when I say it to you, activate your faith, what I'm talking about is you've got to activate what you believe in the Word of God.
当我说启动你的信心的时候呢，它的意思就是要启动你对神话语的信念。
See, a faith in a person just cannot increase by itself.
你看，一个人的信心是没有办法自自然然增长的。
The faith of God comes through the Word of God.
神的信心必须和神的话语结合在一起。
Many people don't even pick up the word to read to build their faith.
有些人从来不读圣经来建立他们的信心。
They just want God to give it to them.
他们只是要神把东西赐给他们。
See, God is not going to just give it to us.
神不会这样白白的把东西给我们。
See, once a pastor was asked a question.
曾经有一位牧师问了这个问题。
He had been ministering in the nations about healing.
他在不同的国家里面做这个医治大能。
Pastor, many in your meetings get healed.
他们问牧师啊，在你的聚会当中有很多人得医治。
And many of these people are not even saved.
但是这些人啊，有很多还没有得救的。
And he said something that just I still remember till today.
他说了的话。直到今天我还记得清清楚楚。
He said in the case of a non-believer,
他说在没有信主的人身上
the compassion of God moves over them.
神的慈悲感动了他们。
But in the case of a believer, he expects the word of God to work in us.
但是在信徒的身上神希望神的话语在我们的生命当中运行。
We have to activate our faith to receive from God.
我们一定要启动我们的信心，才能够从神有所领受。
See, there is enough power to heal anyone who needs healing.
其实神有足够的大能，能够医治所有需要医治的人。
It says in Luke chapter 5, verse 17, he says, one of those days as He was teaching, there were Pharisees and teachers of the law sitting by, who had come from every village and town of Galilee and Judea and from Jerusalem, and the power of the Lord was present with him to heal them.
路加福音第五章十七节说，有一天，耶稣教训人，有法利赛人和教法师在旁边坐着，他们是从加利利各乡村和犹太并耶路撒冷来的。主的能力与耶稣同在，使他能医治病人。
Notice two things here.
请你注意两件事。
It says the power was present to heal. Jesus was anointed with that power.
这里说主的能力与耶稣同在，这个能力呢，使到耶稣能够医治病人。
And number two, it says since the power was present, but nobody got healed.
但是第二方面我们看到虽然能力与耶稣同在但是没人得医治。
See, the only person that got healed was the paralyzed man.
唯一一个得医治的就是那个瘫子。
He was lowered through the roof into that house.
他是从房顶上被坠下去的。
With his four friends.
他的四个朋友把他坠到当中。
And Jesus said, because of their faith,
耶稣说因着你们的信
that the power of God flowed through that man and healed him.
神的大能就流经那个瘫子的身上使他得医治。
It was the faith of those men and the paralyzed man that activated the healing power to work.
是那个瘫子和四个朋友的能力启动了神的大能。
As you are watching this program, I want you to activate your faith in whatever you need from the Lord.
当你看这个节目的时候，希望你能够启动你的信心，以至于你能够让神来满足你的需要。
Whatever your need is, the power is present. Just activate your faith and receive it.
无论你的信心是什么，只要启动你的信心，那么神的大能就会在你的身上工作。
Let us pray together.
让我们一起祷告。
Lord, we just thank you for your power that is present all around us.
主啊，为着你的大能在我们的周围，我们要感谢你。
I pray, Father, everybody that has a need will plug into your power today.
主啊，我祷告，凡是有需要的人，他们都能够和你的大能连接在一起。
Receive what they need today.
领受他们应该领受的。
And we thank you for that in Jesus' name. Amen.
为着这一切，我们感谢你，奉耶稣基督的名，阿门。
Our time has come to an end.
节目来到尾声。
Until we meet next time, God bless you.
下回同样的时间再会，神赐福给你。
主耶稣是王，拥有天上地下的权柄，尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。主耶稣是王，拥有天上地下的权柄，尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。
主耶稣是王，拥有天上地下的权柄，尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。主耶稣是王，拥有天上地下的权柄，尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。
所以我们要是欢迎做主的门徒，奉父子圣灵的名，从这里到地极，一直释放宣扬报告主耶和华的信念。主耶稣是王，拥有天上地下的权柄，尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。主耶稣是王，拥有天上地下的权柄，尊贵的羔羊，是万民做主的门徒，奉父子圣灵的名，从这里到地极，一直释放宣扬报告主耶和华的信念。所以我们要是万民做主的门徒，奉父子圣灵的名，从这里到地极，一直释放宣扬报告主耶和华的信念。主耶稣是王，拥有天上地下的权柄，尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。主耶稣是王，拥有天上地下的权柄，尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。主耶稣是王，拥有天上地下的权柄，尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。主耶稣拥有天上地下的权柄，尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。
尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。尊贵的羔羊，我们高举你生命。